فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We're still in the explanation of the book ثلاثة الأصول, written by شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. We've previously mentioned 9 types of عبادات in which the Shaykh rahimahullah brought and their evidences. And inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to go into an-naw'u al-ashir, the 10th type, min anwa'i al-ibadah, from the types of ibadat which the author mentioned. And this one is going to be al-isti'anah. So as we always do, we're going to define al-isti'anah lughatan wa istilaha, and then we're going to go more into ayat and ahadiths pertaining to al-isti'anah. Ibn Manzur rahimahullah, he has a book called Lisan al-Arab. And when he was talking about maddatu awn, the term awn, what it means. The word isti'anah is mazdaru isti'ana wa huwa min al-awni. Isti'ana comes from the verbal noun al-awn. And he said, after he brought the ayah wasta'inu bis-sabri was-salah, he says, wal-awnu al-zahiru ala al-amri, is to support and aid in a matter. Until he said, wa taqulu, the Arabs, they say, a'antuhu i'anatan wasta'antuhu wasta'antu bihi fa'anani wa ta'awanu alayya wa'tawanu. أعان بعضهم بعضا وتعاونا أعان بعضنا بعضا والمعونة الإعانة ورجل معوان حسن المعونة وكثير المعونة للناس وكل شيء أعانك فهو عون لك كالصوم عون على العبادة. And that's the usage of the word. It comes from the word awn, and it means al-zahiru ala al-amri, help, support in a matter. That's what it linguistically means. Istilahan, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah defined it in his book Majmu' al-Fatawa, first volume, page 103. Ibn Taymiyyah says, al-isti'anatu, it is talabul awni min Allahi, it is to seek, because the word isti'anah, pay attention, Ibn Taymiyyah is defining it. He said, isti'ana means what? Talab al-awni min Allah. Where did he bring the word talab from? The alif and the sin show isti'ana. It means what? Talab, show asking. Al-awnu min Allah, help and support from Allah. Wa yutlabu min al-makhluqi ma yaqdiru alayhi min al-umuri. And isti'ana is also seeked from the creation in that which they are able to do. Sah? And that we're going to see inshallah ta'ala later bi'idhnillah al-kareem wa al-istighatha means, right? But the difference between isti'ana and istighatha, we're going to touch on it inshallah ta'ala. But the farq between the two of them is that istighatha is specific to the times of hardship. Istighatha. Whereas the word isti'ana is not restricted to just times of hardship, nor is it restricted to the times of ease. So it's more of a comprehensive word. What's the reality? What is the need, sorry? حَاجَّةُ الْعَبْدِ إِلَى الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ بِاللَّهِ دُونَ مَا سِوَهِ. The need that the creation, the slave, has to isti'ana for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, asking help from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the need that he has for it, besides anything else. Ibn Rajab rahimahullah says a powerful statement in his great book Jami'u al-Ulum wal-Hikam. He says, Al-Abdu, the slave, muhtajun, he requires and he needs, إِلَى الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ بِاللَّهِ, in seeking help from Allah, فِي فِعْلِ الْمَأْمُورَاتِ, in the good that you want to do, وَتَرْكِ الْمَحْظُورَاتِ, in leaving the evil that you're prohibited from, وَالصَّبْرُ عَلَى الْمَقْدُورَاتِ كُلِّهَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَعِنْدَ الْمَوْتِ, and patience on the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destined for you, all of them in this world, وَعِنْدَ الْمَوْتِ, and at the time of death, وَبَعْدَهُ, and also even after death, مِنْ أَهْوَالِ الْبَرْزَقِ, from the distress and the hardship of the grave and the day of judgment. And then he goes on to say, وَلَا يَقْدِرُ عَلَى الْإِعَانَةِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And no one is able to help you in all of those stages and in all of those places except Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And then he goes on to say, فَمَنْ حَقَّقَ الْإِسْتِعَانَةَ عَلَيْهِ فِي ذَلِكَ كُلِّهِ أَعَانَهُ اللَّهِ. Whoever makes sure he truly comes with isti'ana on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, in all of that, أَعَانَهُ اللَّهِ, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is also going to give him aid and support. وَمَنْ تَرَكَ الْإِسْتِعَانَةَ بِاللَّهِ, and anyone who leaves off seeking help from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, وَاسْتَعَانَ بِغَيْرِهِ, and he also then goes on to seeking help from other than Allah, وَكَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَى مَنْ إِسْتِعَانَ بِهِ, then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will leave you to the individual or to the thing in which you have seeked help from, and where you sought help from. فَصَارَ مَخْذُولًا, then the individual becomes humiliated, وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ فِي أُمُورِ الدُّنْيَا لِأَنَّهُ عَاجِزٌ عَنِ الْإِسْتِقْلَالِ بِجَلْبِ مَصَالِحِهِ وَدَفْعِ مَضَارِّهِ. فَصَارَ, then the person becomes مَخْذُولًا, one who is humiliated, one who is degraded. وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ, and it is like that in his worldly affairs. Because you know why? لأنه عاجز عن الاستقلال, because you are unable to independently bring for yourself بجلب المصالحه, the good that you need, and even the thing that you're asking is also not able to independently bring the good that you're looking for. ودفع مضاره, and to repel the harm from you, you can't do that independently from yourself, and nor can that person independently do it for you. When we say independent, we mean without Allah tabarak wa ta'ala being the one helping you or that individual. وَلَا مُعِينَ لَهُ عَلَى مَصَالِحِ دِينِهِ وَدُنْيَاهُ جَمِيعًا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And there's no one able to help you in your religious benefits and in your worldly benefits, both of them, except Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then he goes on to say, فَمَنْ أَعَانَهُ اللَّهُ, anyone who Allah gives him help and support, فَهُوَ الْمُعَانُ, then that person has truly been helped and he has truly been supported. وَمَنْ خَذَلَهُ اللَّهُ, and anyone who Allah chooses not to aid and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala humiliates and degrades them, فَهُوَ الْمَخْذُولُ, then he truly is a degraded, humiliated individual. وَهَذَا هُوَ التَّحْقِيقُ مَعْنَى قَوْلِ الْعَبْدِ, and that's the true meaning of the statement of the person when the person says, لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, that I have no strength, I have no ability except Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَالْمَعْنَى, and the meaning means, أَنَّ الْعَبْدَ, that the slave, لَا يَتَحَوَّلُ حَالُهُ مِنْ حَالٍ إِلَى حَالٍ. When you say لَا حَوْلَ, what you're trying to say is my situation cannot move from one situation to another situation. وَلَا قُوَّةَ And no, your strength cannot come from one strength to another strength, except with Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's help and support. So that statement of Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahimahullah teaches us a lot. That is, do you want to do good? You need Allah to help you. Do you want to stay from that which is prohibited from you? You need Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to help you and support you. Are you also trying to be patient? Trying to be patient in what? In the things that you're afflicted with, the hardship that you go through, the pain and the agony and the suffering that you're enduring. There's no one else to help you out there except Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So that statement of his is powerful. And it truly goes under the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because as he speaks on, he brings that hadith, which is the Prophet's statement, احرص على ما ينفعك, strive to that which will benefit you. واستعن بالله ولا تعجز, and seek help from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and don't be lazy and weak. So the person has to realize that you can strive to that which benefits you, but if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala doesn't aid or support you in it and doesn't give you the strength, then you as an individual are not going to truly be able to bring the good that you want for yourself, and you truly will not be able to repel and get rid of the harm which is making its way to you. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, if you analyze his statement, especially in his kitab Madarij al-Sarikin, which is explaining Manazil Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in, the book of Ibn Ismail al-Harawi, when he came to Isti'ana and he was talking about it, what he did was Sawa Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah بين التوكل والاستعانة. He kind of makes isti'ana and tawakkul the same thing, and he makes them equal, and he says that they're both the same, rahimahullah. And that's not really characteristics of Ibn al-Qayyim. He always tries to find a distinct differences between things, but what he chose was that he put them both in the same category, and he said that isti'ana and tawakkul are the same, and he defined them the same, rahimahullah ta'ala. Now we want to speak about the station and the place that isti'ana is in our religion. Okay? Manzilatu isti'ana, the status, the position of isti'ana, and how the weight it holds in our religion. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, I'm going to read a statement of his, alayhi rahmatullahi, may Allah have mercy on him. He says, and this statement of his, it can be found in his kitab Madarij al-Salikin, the first volume, page 86 to 87. He says, al-isti'anatu tajma'u aslayni. He says the isti'ana, it combines two fundamental elements. And the first one is al-thiqatu billahi, trust in Allah. Wal-i'timadi alayhi, and reliance on Him. So isti'ana, it holds two powerful compounds, two fundamental elements. And they are, first one is al-thiqatu billahi, you trust Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Wal-i'timadi alayhi, and you rely on Him. And you rely on Him. And then he says, فَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ قَدْ يَثِقُ بِالْوَاحِدِ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَهُوَ مَعَ ذَلِكَ لَا يَعْتَمِدُ عَلَيْهِ لِاسْتِغْنَائِهِ عَنْهُ. He says, Ibn al-Qayyim, for verily a person, a human being, a slave, may trust an individual from the creation, may trust a human being, but even then, he doesn't rely on him. Because he's what? He's self-sufficient. He doesn't need him. Also, he says, وَقَدْ يَعْتَمِدُ, but he may rely on another person, مَعَ عَدَمِ ثِقَتِهِ بِهِ, even though he doesn't fully trust him. Why? لِحَاجَتِ إِلَيْهِ, because he needs him. There's no other alternatives out there. وَلِعَدَمِ مَنْ يَقُومُ مُقَامَهُ, and he has no other person to take this place. So he's forced to rely on this person. Okay? فيحتاج إلى اعتمادي عليه مع أنه غير واثق به. Even though he doesn't trust him. Are you there? But Allah تبارك وتعالى, these are the two that are present in him, and that is استعانة. الثقة بالله, that you trust Allah تبارك وتعالى, والاعتماد عليه, and both of those have to come in you. If one is absent, then that's not true استعانة. And that's not the power and the status of الاستعانة. Now the author rahimahullah, he brought that ayah from the Quran, which is to use as an evidence of isti'ana. And what surah is greater than the surah in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "A'zamu suratin fi kitabillah." It is the greatest surah in the Quran. Hadith of Abi Sa'id ibn Mu'alla, right? The Shaykh brought the ayah from سورة الفاتحة إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. The question that one may ask himself is that why is it that the ibadah was put before استعانة? Why was it said إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين and not إياك نستعين وإياك نعبد? Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he gives 10 answers. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he gives 10 answers. So inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go through them. Powerful points. And they all could be found in his kitab, Madariju Marjalu Sarikin. Number one. So he says there's a wisdom behind it. Ibn al-Qayyim says, وَتَقْدِيمُ الْعِبَادَةِ عَلَى الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ. The reason why the ibadah was put before the isti'ana is for reasons. Lima yali, and he says as follows. Number one is لأن العبادة غاية العباد التي خلقوا لها والاستعانة وسيلة إليها. The first reason is because ibadah is the ultimate goal in why Allah تبارك وتعالى created the creation. And isti'ana is a means to that ultimate goal, which is ibadah. ومن ثم, and because of that, يكون ذلك من قبيل تقديم الغايات على الوسائل. And that's putting the goal before the means. So it will enter the angle of putting forward the goal before the means. Number two. He says, لِأَنَّ إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. Number two is because إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ مُتَعَلِّقٌ بِأُلُوهِيَتِهِ. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ is connected to Allah's uluhiyya. Subhana. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ is connected to what? مُتَعَلَّقٌ بِرُبُوبِيَتِهِ is connected to his what? His rububiyya. And so which one is more important, the two of them? Uluhiyya or rububiyya? It is the uluhiyya because the rububiyya was not موطن النزاع. It was not the point of argument between prophets and his nations. Okay? Prophets and his nations, they didn't have an argument regarding rububiyya. The real discussion was about uluhiyya. And so that was the first important point that prophets were commanded to call to. So that's why it came first. That's what he's trying to say here. Number three. He says, لِأَنَّ تَقْدِيمَ الْعِبَادَةِ عَلَى الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ يَتَنَاسَبُ مَعَ تَقْدِيمِ اسْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَى لَفْظِ الرَّبِّ الْمَذْكُورَيْنِ فِي أَوَّلِ السُّورَةِ. He says, because the reason why ibadah was put before isti'ana is because Allah's name came first in the beginning of the surah. Allah came first, the word لفظ الجلالة, Allah came first before the word الرب. So when you read Fatiha, what do you say? الحمد لِلَّهِ. Allah came first. Then you say رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And so إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ is connected to الْأُلُوهِيَّ, you said, which is Allah. And then إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, you said, is connected to what? الْرُبُوبِيَّ, which is the word رَبِّ. So since in the beginning the word Allah came first, then now also the word Iyyaka na'budu should come first. And Iyyaka wa Iyyaka nasta'in is connected to Ulu Rububiyya, so Rabb should go next. Does that make sense? Number four. لأن العبادة المطلقة تتضمن الاستعانة من غير عكس. The fourth reason is because the unrestricted ibadah, it consists of al-isti'ana, but not the opposite. So ibadah unrestrictedly involves isti'ana, and this is where we say atful khasi ala al-ami, right? Isn't that what we say? Somebody may ask you and say to you in a discussion, may say to you, so if isti'ana is a ibadah, why was it said Iyyaka na'budu and not? Why was it said Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in? If isti'ana is a ibadah, like you're saying right now, ibadah was just mentioned and isti'ana was mentioned right after it. Does that make sense? We'll say that al-ibadah al-mutlaqa, the unrestricted use of the word ibadah, isti'ana falls under it. But does isti'ana fall under ibadah? Not necessarily, no. Because مثلا, what he means by that is فَكُلُّ عَابِدٍ, everyone who's worshipping Allah, عُبُودِيَّةً تَامَّةً. Anyone who's worshipping Allah, a ibadah which is complete, then that person is مُسْتَعِينٌ. He's what? He's مُسْتَعِين. He's seeking help from Allah. وَلَا يَنْعَكِسُ الْأَمْرُ. Are you there? Number five, which is also roughly the same, but he says, لأن الاستعانة جزء من العبادة, because استعانة is a portion of عبادة, not the opposite. فقدم الكل على الجزء. So you give precedence to the كل, which is the general over the specific. The sixth reason is because isti'ana is help from Allah. Are you with me? And ibadah is a request for Allah. So what is for Allah takes precedence what is from Allah. He says, وَلِأَنَّ الْإِسْتِعَانَةَ طَلَبٌ مِّنْهُ سُبْحَانَهُ والعبادة طلب له فقدم ما هو له على ما هو منه. He says, استعانة is to request from him سبحانه وتعالى. And عبادة is طلب له, is a request for him سبحانه وتعالى. فقدم, so precedence was given to ما هو له, that which is for him, على ما هو منه, over that which is from him. Number seven is that لِأَنَّ الْعِبَادَةَ لَا تَكُونُ إِلَّا مِنْ مُخْلِصٍ مُخْلِصٍ وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةَ تَكُونُ مِنْ مُخْلِصٍ وَمِنْ غَيْرِ مُخْلِصٍ. He says, ibadah cannot be except from one who is sincere. As for isti'ana, it can be from a mukhlis and it can be from one who is not mukhlis. And because of that, وَمِنْ ثَمَّ قُدِّمَ مَا هُوَ مَحْضُ الْإِخْلَاصِ. And because of that, the one who is sincerity is pure is being given precedence to the one that can have sincerity and not sincerity. Number eight, he says, وَلِأَنَّ الْعِبَادَةَ حَقُّ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَوْجَبَهُ عَلَى الْعَبْدِ وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةُ طَلَبُ الْعَوْنِ عَلَى الْعِبَادَةِ. Number eight is that ibadah is the rights of Allah in which He has made obligatory upon the slaves. Whereas isti'ana is a request for the ibadah. So this would enter min babi taqdim al-ahammi ala al-muhimmi. That's what it will enter. Number 9. He says wa li'anna al-ibadata shukrun li ni'matihi 'alayka. Ibadah is expressing gratitude to the blessing Allah has bestowed upon you. Wallahu yuhibbu, and Allah loves an yushkara, for gratitude to be expressed to Him. Whereas isti'ana, wal i'ana fi'luhu bika, it's Allah's action for you. Wa tawfiquhu laka, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you the ability in a matter. Last but not least, number 10 is he says لأن إياك نعبد لله, because إياك نعبد is for Allah تبارك وتعالى, وإياك نستعين is به. Is for the ibadah. Or it's bihi, meaning from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, his kalam here, it shows a lot of fawaid in just Surah Al-Fatiha. That one particular ayah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We now want to go into أَقْسَامُ النَّاسِ فِي الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ, categorizing the people when it comes to isti'ana. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he categorizes them into four. He categorizes them into four. When it comes to isti'ana, the people are four types. The first one of them is, هو أجلها وأفضلها, and this is the best of them all. It is, أهل العبادة والاستعانة بالله عليها, وهذا أجل الأقسام وأفضلها. The first one is Ahlul Ibadah, the people of Ibadah. Walisti'anati billahi, and they rely on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So their ultimate goal is what? Walisti'anati billahi alayha. Fa'ibadatullahi ghayatu muradihim. Worshipping Allah is their ultimate goal. And they request from Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do they request from Him? أَنْ يُعِينَهُمْ عَلَيْهَا, that Allah helps them on this ultimate goal of theirs, which is to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُوَفِّقَهُمْ لِلْقِيَامِ بِهَا, so they can stand up to do it. So here Ibn al-Qayyim is going to be speaking about what the types of people they are in terms of isti'ana and also ibadah. Not just isti'ana alone, but also ibadah. بحسب العبادة والاستعانة. The second type, he says, is أهل الإعراض عن العبادة والاستعانة. The second type of people is those who have turned away. Where are they turned away from? عن عبادتي, worshipping Allah تبارك وتعالى. And they also turned away from what? وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةُ بِهِ, and also seeking help from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. They've turned away from both. And if he does seek help from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he does it for his own shahawat. La ala marzati rabbihi wa huquqihi. And he doesn't do it in pleasing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Naam. The third type of people is مَلَّهُ نَوْعِ عِبَادَةٍ بِلَاسْتِعَانَةٍ أَوْ بِإِسْتِعَانَةٍ نَاقِصَةٍ. The third one is a group who have a type of ibadah without any isti'ana lakin. Or they have isti'ana which is deficient. And he says, وَهَؤُلَاءِ صِنْفَان وَهَؤُلَاءِ صِنْفَان أَمَ نَوْعَان. They are two types of people. The first one is القدرية. And they're the ones who say بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ جَعَلَ بِالْعَبْدِ جَمِيعَ مَقْدُورِهِ. That Allah تبارك وتعالى سبحانه وتعالى, he has done to the slave and destined everything for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, Allah has done everything, so there's no need for you to help ask him for anything. Allah has done everything for you already. So there's no place for you to ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for anything. He sent messengers down for you. He established a proof against you. He sent down a book on you, and etc. So there's nothing for you to ask, and there's nothing for you to help request from him. Allah gave you a healthy body. He gave you a healthy lifestyle. He also clarified the path for you. He sent a messenger on you. He also gave you the ability to do this particular action. They say, وَلَمْ يَبْقَ بَعْدَ هَذَا إِعَانَةٌ مَقْدُورَةٌ يَسْأَلُهَا إِيَّاهَا. There's no room left for you then to request anything more for Allah. Everything you needed, he's given it to you. The second one within the third type is لهم عبادات. They have actions. Are you there? They have actions. وله أوراد. They have dhikr and wird that they do. But there's deficiency in their isti'ana. The fourth type, which is the last, is, he says, هم أولئك الذين يشهدون تفرد الله بالنفع والضر. Sorry, والضر. The fourth type is those who testify that Allah تبارك وتعالى is alone in bringing good and harm. And wherever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala wills, it will be. And whatever He wills, it won't be. These ones, he said, مع ذلك, even then, توكل عليه, they relied on him سبحانه وتعالى, واستعان به على حظوظه وشهواته وأغراضه. Naam, so he said, وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ even then تَوَكَّلَ عَلَيْهِ they relied on Allah, وَاسْتَعَانَ بِهِ they seeked help from him subhanahu wa ta'ala, عَلَى حُضُوذِهِ in their desires and their shahawat and their worldly gain. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions those four. So inshallah ta'ala, we'll stop there bi-idhnillah al-kareem. And we'll speak about the ayat and the hadith pertaining to al-isti'ana. Next lesson bi-idhnillah al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. استغفرك وأتوب إليه